Vede ratata bhar bhar. Pavata nahi parama bhar. Ui sura sura nara.
Sura sura nara.
Sura sura nara. Your glory is beyond definition. Mahima bhar. All Vedas insistently repeat your glories. None can understand or go beyond you.
Mahima tumari apar, Mahima tumari apar, Veda ratat bhar bhar,
Veda ratat bhar bhar,
Pavat nahi param bhar, Pavat nahi param bhar.
O Lord, listen to my prayer. Grant me the boon of being your devotee. Brahmananda meditates you. You, this insignificant, falls at your lotus feet.
Natha meri arajaman, Natha meri arajaman, Natha meri arajaman, Natha
Jo apni bhakti daan,
Jo apni
We have 10 minutes. We will read some few portions of the Bhagavatam. Words of Papa. Paramatman is the great truth which pervades the universe, expresses itself as the universe. Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. Verily everything is Brahman. There is nothing but Brahman. This truth is attained by the practice of the two Mahavakyas, Tattvamasi and Aham Brahmasmi. Tattvamasi means the word that. In this conception, the ego sense disappears. There is only Brahman. Aham Brahmasmi means I am Brahman and there is nothing besides myself. So Brahman is everything, manifest and manifest. In the Gita, the supreme reality is described as Purushottama, who is Purusha, Prakriti and beyond. The words are Vasudeva Sarvamidhi in Shloka give the real meaning of the realization. Everything that exists is Vasudeva. Visible, invisible, manifest, unmanifest. Everything is Brahman, nothing but Brahman. Every now and then when the Hare Rama, they will immediately say, Vasudeva, Vasudeva. No. Every now and then we are reminded, he is there, he is Vasudeva means those who are residing within. Ego sense, that is the reality. Ego sense has no existence in it. Ego sense is an illusion. When you realize the truth, you see yourself everywhere. You have manifested as the entire universe and all the things in it. There is nothing but Brahman. The I in the body does not die. I is the reality of truth. Without the truth, the body is nothing. You are the changeless, birthless, deathless, spiritual Atman. Who is born and who dies, find out. Atman alone is real and the real has no birth and death. You identify yourself in the body and say, I am born, I am dying, I am changing. There is no reality about birth and death. One who puts on and removes the body is eternal and he is the only truth. Devotee, great personalities like Arjuna and Krishna, were they not in human form? Papa, forms are immaterial. They are represented the great truths. We revere them not for the sake of the body, but for the sake of the reality dwelling within the body. The great truth manifested itself in those forms. When the body dies, the spirit does not die. Then death must be to the body. What is the meaning of saying free yourself from birth and death? Janana marana tapahara. Birth and death of what? In the light of the Atman, there is no rebirth. The Jnani does not believe that he has ever had any birth or death. He believes that Atman alone is, and he is that. The body that appears is a mystery. The whole world manifestation, ever changing and changing and changing, is a mystery. Birth signifies a creation. There is nothing that is created. Likewise, there is no disintegration. These are all ideas. They are no significant when we look at them from the standpoint of the reality, capital R. Atman alone is real. In the relative sense, we accept all of them. In the absolute sense, they cannot be true, they are not true. When we consider ourselves to be the body, then there is the question of birth which gives joy and of death which gives pain. It is all mental. It depends upon the way we look at things. Through a tainted vision, we see things and therefore we suffer. in the absolute consciousness, these words have no meaning. If we think of them as true, then we are caught up. We are then involved in the relative, and the result is confusion and misery. We labor under a delusion. Can we say disintegration is death? So many component parts join together and form a body. Then start disintegration and parts go asunder. A machine is made up of so many parts. When it is worn out, the parts come off. Is the construction to be taken as birth and disintegration as death? In the same way, bodies come and go. The spirit within is the one we have to realize. That is the reality. Other things integrate and disintegrate. That is of no importance. When the Atman is realized, body consciousness is transcendent. In that state, you are conscious of the spirit, which is birthless, deathless. So birth and death is realized as a sheer illusion. That is why we say, when the body disintegrates, he does not die. He means the spirit within. He does not undergo any change because it is unborn and therefore eternal, undying. As the expression goes, the world is too much with us. You can say the body is too much with us. Man is under the illusion, I am the body. I identify itself with the body. Really, I is Atman, which is not the body. Truth cannot be found in books. It can be found only by experiencing it. Books do not help you. So lay them aside. Then by sadhana, by reflection, by meditation, try to get that experience. Experience cannot be imparted to others by words. All your preconceived notions about the Supreme Reality crumble down. They vanish like mist before the sun. You find them to be utterly false. These are conditions laid down, certain methods prescribed for us to go inward, to realize, to experience the truth. So far, books and sayings help. They guide you on the path. They cannot give you that experience. Nobody can. A person who has realized the truth should guide you, and you should follow the path prescribed by him. Then you are sure to get that experience. Books teach different ways, so you are confused. They can provoke interest or curiosity in you. Even the Bhagavad Gita creates a desire to attain the highest, that's all. Each one has to find for oneself the true path for him or her. Bhakti or jnana or karma. So many paths are shown in the Bhagavad Gita. Even if you take only any one of them, still no clear idea is given about how to walk the path. A guru must guide you. Therefore, importance is given to the guru. You must go to the guru, do namaskar to him, put questions, get instructions about the path, obey those instructions, walk on the path. This is said in the Bhagavad Gita. A spiritual guide or master is essential. By reading books, you cannot get anything. Devotee, in spite of bodily ailment, you are always bubbling with the bliss. When I look at you, it brings me immense joy. Papa, he is bliss itself. Devotee, we have read many books on religion, but reading is not believing. Seeing is believing. Papa, you have a great responsibility. You have to take us to the kingdom of God. Papa, there is no question of taking you away from one place to another. You are where you should be. You have to realize this. Devotee, this Ramnam is the name of Rama, son of Dasharatha, Papa. Ram is the supreme being who has become everything, the whole universe, with all beings, creatures and things. Still he is beyond everything. He is also Rama, the son of Dasharatha. He is also Krishna, the son of Devaki. He is also Buddha, Jesus, etc. Ramnam existed even before Dasharatha Ram was born. Brahman is Ram. In that sense, Ramdas was repeating Ramnam. Is it necessary to have a form while thinking of Ram? Papa, no form. Name is God. Form will come and go. You can have the name always under tongue. The sound is so sweet. You concentrate on the sound and it will take you beyond name and form to Brahman, who you are and who is seated in your heart. This is an independent sadhana where there is no need for any external object. It is easy when you repeat Ram Nam, God is on your tongue. You can have the name always on your tongue. The sound is so sweet. You concentrate on the sound, it will take you beyond name and form to Brahman, who you are. We started with that, no? Who you are is the real question. Now Papa is giving the methodology. It will take you are, who is seated in your heart. This is an independent sadhana, where there is no need for any external object. It is easy. When you repeat Ram Nam, God is on your tongue. So today, so many small points. Papa started with what constitutes spirituality or religion. It is to go back to the origin of our and the world. And then the real quest begins, who really I am. That means I am not what I assume myself to be. Then he brought out the coconut, he brought out the Atma Bodh, and the Atma Bodh, the description was given about the three bodies, gross, subtle, and causal body, and the Atma is beyond that. So through the simile of the coconut, where the outer cover, the coir, then shell, and the kernel, and the tuft. All those things have been beautifully explained so that we will try to connect ourselves. With every object we may be able to connect, but coconut now seems to be easy for us. Why are we offering coconut? We do that. It is not Nadigeri Gandhatvijam. Now we understand that this is how we are connected to the Almighty Lord of the universe who is seated within. Then he took us to a bhajan, and then again he closes with his own words of what? Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi. And finally he takes the Nama and he says, the moment you chant, God is on your tongue. Let us try to carry as much messages as possible today, and so that our progress gets hastened. We pray from the deep chamber of our heart to give us the needed push and to make us aware that He is there, He is guiding us. If we forget about it, our priorities will be different, our preferences will be different, and we will lose the track. We are not asked to run away from any creation, any job, any environment, any involvement. Only we have to find that it is also a form of God. Papa is not asking any one of us to renounce and go to different realm. Wants us to see, divinize everything. See that aspect in everything, so that you love all and serve all based upon that vision. Hari Om. Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram.